I greet this day with the love in my heart. Welcome to Indian Stock Mind Dynamics. Today the tip of the day is POT technique, POT technique. This day, 9th January, is marked a wonderful day for us. In 1915, our Mahatma Gandhi, father of our nation, has returned from South Africa. You know why did he? When he come back, he had a determination to bring independence to a country. The same day, 9th January, happened to be NRI Day, celebrated all over the world, non-resident India, to commemorate the contribution done by overseas Indian communities to development of our country. So NRI Day. And the third, in 1558, the Geneva had got a freedom from Bern, Canton, Switzerland. Okay, with all this information, I go to POT technique. The POT technique is nothing but power of thought. The power of thought is nothing but what we decide every day to bring our life into existence. The thought form is, as you know very well, it is emanating from our mind. When the mind determines to think, the thinking process becomes a word. And as you know, the word becomes action. The action brings in desired results. But what's happening, the thought form, at least each thought form has got its own power. So if I started thinking positive, the thought brings positive result. And if I think negative thoughts, the negative impact will be there. It's obviously known to everyone. But how to create this positive thought? The power of thought, how do we understand? See, as I told you, Mahatma Gandhi, when he returned from South Africa, he had undergone the racial discrimination from the British. So when he came, when he was thrown out of the train compartment, he said, only you could throw me out of this compartment, but when I go to India, I will throw you out of the country. That was his determination. So his thought form was very powerful. He could able to achieve the independence through that too, non-violence. You just think about it. And similarly, every thought has got its own action. So for example, if you are a swimmer, you would have remembered a British girl, an American girl, by name Tude Headley. Have you heard about her? The Tude Headley's American girl was the first woman swimmed across English Channel. 34.15 kilometers the length of the English Channels bordering England and France, located in the United Kingdom. When she started doing it, the first attempt she failed, because when she was swimming, four boats have accompanied her with a team of what you call the swimmers, the divers, and also oceanographers, a lot of technologists to observe her swimming. Because some areas in the length are infested with the shark, so they had to be very careful. But in one of the boat, her mother was sitting and watching a small child swimming across the channel, in the English Channel. See, the determination of the mother is, her child wants to be in one of the limelight of achievement. Because in a young stage, when the girl was in 2 years, his father left her. So the mother kept on telling her, your father should realize that you are potential. So one day or other, you should make some achievement in life. That transformed the thought into the child. The child is now swimming. The first time she failed, you know why she failed? As she was going, it was a misty and a foggy day, and she could not see the goal, in the sense of the distance. So she withdrew. After withdrawing from the swimming, she realized only quarter miles away. Next time when it was clear, she could able to do it, and she was the first woman who swim across the English Channel. See, what I am trying to tell you, that girl took the thought form very seriously, and she could able to fulfill her mother's desire. So children who are watching these videos, you have some desire, some goals, have it very clearly, and please do it for the sake of, not only for you, to satisfy your parents. At the same time, parents also are telling, don't put too many things into your child's mind. Give them a little bit freedom to think and let them choose the path they could be able to succeed. So, thinking process. See, the frustrated mind always have an imbalanced status of life. The frustrated mind. The fruitful thought, the mind, have a fruitful results. So, make your children to think fruitfully, positively, to attain lot of good things in life. And hope you also do that from today. Okay, and we keep talking about this POT technique, the power of thought is very enormous if you understand it. Okay, so from today, I'm going to give you some serious thought about your POT technique. And today, this is what I've given it to you. Thank you for watching. May you all be blessed.